This video is about controlling the result generated by the Wan 2.2 model using the first and last frame. We'll also look at the new four-step Lora released by Lightx2V and a few other published by individual creators. Let's begin with the Wan 2.2 Lightning Lora, which is capable of completing the task in just four steps. And these are the Lora released yesterday. Below, these two are for the text-to-video workflows, but with different versions to it. This is version 1, and above is a slightly better version 1.1. Inside this, there should be two files respective to high and low noise models. This is the image-to-video Lora which I have used, if I open it. Below are the safe-to-insert files, the Lora, with a file size of around 1.2 GB. These are large in comparison to the other accelerator we used earlier. Both of these Lora will be used with the high and low noise models. Similar to these, a smaller version of the same Lightning Lora has been released by Kijai. The larger text-to-video Lora we saw earlier, these are the smaller versions of the same Lora. These high and low noise Lora are the smaller variants of the version 1.1 we saw before. And these are the smaller variant of the version 1. Above is the smaller version of the image-to-video Lora. With the file size of around 600 megabytes, these are more practical, but at a cost of quality. Now, moving ahead to the workflow, where I will be using two images for the video frames. Link to the workflow and this text file will be shared in the description. Right now, my comfyUI portable only has the custom node manager. And the workflow I will share will expect additional custom nodes. These two are for GGUF models. And then these two are for patching Sage Attention. These both are for unloading models after use. It is for users using a smaller card. Install all the custom nodes. This loading sign sometimes never stops. To avoid this, I suggest installing the missing nodes by opening the manager. The program's output showed nothing. I did a restart, and it worked. The workflow is the same I used in the previous video. And the yellow nodes here require files which I will be downloading. Similar to the previous video, this model chain goes to the second case sampler, and once the case sampler gives an output, the model is then unloaded and the value is then forwarded ahead. If you're using a card with 8 or 12 gigabyte of memory, try generating without these nodes a couple of times and check the performance. The first case sampler also received output from similar nodes, and once the work is done, the high noise model is unloaded and the value is forwarded ahead. These four nodes are for using Sage Attention, which should decrease the generation time. I am using this image of a martial art expert, and my prompt is simple. The martial art expert is practicing. I forgot to show the files used in the yellow node. Let's look at it quickly. First is the UNet, and the link given in the text file will take you to the download page. It is the high noise Q4 model. Similarly, the second link is for the low noise model. Click here to see all the high noise models available. Get a larger model if you have a card with bigger memory. The one I am using should be the best for a 12 gigabyte card. Save both the high and low noise model in the UNet folder. Next is the Lora, the one I can recommend. Click here and you should see all the Lightning Lora for the Wan 2.2 model, which we saw earlier. Save both the high and low noise Lora in the Lora folder. And then select both in the workflow respective to the high and low noise model in the UNet loader. Next is the clip loader. The link will take you to the smaller Q5 encoder. Click here to have the larger file for better results. The last is the VAE. And it is the same I used in Wan 2.1, which goes in the load VAE node. So that was all the files in this workflow. The two images uploaded will go into this Wan first last frame node. The width and height of the result can be adjusted from here. The size here affects the generation time, so you can decrease it to 480 pixels. Below is the length of the video, which is 49 frames that will be 24 frames in a second, which generates a 2-second video. After figuring out the best settings for your case, you can increase the frames and make it longer. Few changes can be made here, like the generation steps. These are the total steps done by both the K-sampler. If you change the total steps to 4, then the first K-sampler should end at the second step, and the second K-sampler should begin from the second step. In the workflow, you see the end step is at 1000, but it will stop once it reaches the total steps. You can also keep the total steps to 5 and process with a high noise model for 2 steps, and then with low noise for 3 steps. The high noise mostly works on the motion, and the low noise focuses on the details. I queued the workflow, and one step on 4060 Ti takes around 30 seconds. The 49 frames took 282 seconds on the first run, but as we know, the first run takes more time. And the result looks good, the motion is smooth, the prompt I used was simple. A martial art expert practicing. So this is from the model. I tried generating again, and the prompt was executed in a second because the seed was fixed. Make sure to change it. So the first run took 282 seconds, and the second run took 208 seconds. The difference is more than a minute. And I do not have any complaints with the result. Next, I tried with the Sage Attention. The generation step now took 18 seconds, and the prompt was executed after 128 seconds. So the difference in generation time is big, but the difference in quality is not much in comparison to the difference in generation time. Make sure to set up Sage Attention, and link to the setting up Sage Attention will be in the description. 1 minute for 24 frames is good for the quality of result given by these models. Note that you can decrease one step from the high noise K-sampler to decrease the generation time even further. I tried generating an image with a low noise model, and it worked great. Maybe I should make a video explaining the workflow. I took this image from the internet. My prompt was simple. The cat walks and transforms into a dragon. The result looks fine, but not impressive. Let's look at another result. This image was generated using the Quinn model in my previous video. I used the Flux context model to get the first frame. In this workflow, even this is not the original image. So this is the original image generated using Quinn model, and then this was the second version where the door was fixed using Flux context model. And this is the final image, where the person became normal. The normal person was kept as the first frame, and the angry person as the last frame. And the prompt used was super simple, because it was written by myself. For this result, the prompt was written by GPT, and the result looks better. Using the Flux context model, I generated the same character from a different angle, and then asked GPT for a video prompt about a snow climber falling. After a few tries, you should be able to generate decent results. The subject in this example looks good. So I generated again with a larger Q8 model and expected something better. I got the result in 342 seconds, and it was long due to the first generation. The result generated was similar to the Q4 video because the prompt was not changed and both the models followed the prompt. The Light X2V had also released an 8-step Lora for Quinn model, which should help generate image faster. I will try later and post some images if it works. I think that should be enough. Links and workflow will be in the description. Let me know if the video was helpful.